So if you look at Genesis 6:6, I don't know if it's in the Judaic Bible as well, but if you look at the Old Testament, it says God regretted. Do you believe that?
Pain.
He was pained.
It doesn't actually say regret.
So he regretted. So tell me, why would God regret about something that he's already aware of?
It's a mistranslation to regret.
How would you translate Genesis 6:6?
Pain.
Just pain, which means he regrets.
No.
Yes.
Sometimes you have to do certain things which you know are going to bring undesirable consequences.
No. You know why it pained him? You know what is the context
sometimes
of that verse?
Sometimes you have to do things which are, you know, the lesser of the two evils.
Do you know the context of that verse?
Can I give you an example? Yeah?
No, wait. Let's talk about this.
Your father.
Let's talk about this verse. Do you know the context of that verse? Genesis 6:6.
I'll
get it out.
Get it out. Because it is about the creation of mankind that he regretted.
But speak to him
are you a father? Yeah?
I'm a father.
Have you ever had to discipline your children?
Have I disciplined? Yes.
Does it hurt you that you have to do it? You have to give them a punishment. Does it bother you that you have to do that?
Yes.
But you still do it, don't you? But you are pained by what you did. Do you regret punishing your children?
I regret punishing? No.
But you just said it pains you.
You misunderstood the question, that's why. You were not listening to what I said. It is not, did I regret having a child?
You asked.
Listen. It is as if me asking you, are you a father?
No.
You're not a father yet, okay. You have a father, right?
Yes.
Did he ever regret having you?
No,
he didn't. This is what happens in that verse in Genesis 6:6. He regretted creating mankind.
He was pained over what happened.
Wait a minute. You're not listening again. Even before I finish the question, you want to answer. Listen to the question first. It is about the creation of human beings. In Genesis 3, we read that he was pleased with his creation. In Genesis 6:6, he regretted his creation.
He was upset with how things turned out.
You tell me what it says then. Go on.
It says we considered.
No, you tell me what it says in your Talmud. Sorry, in Genesis 6:6.
Okay. The Hebrew says, "Vayinochin Hashem, God reconsidered, he also et ha'olam ba'oed, he had made man in the land, and he was upset in his heart."
He was upset in the heart, regretted.
Regret.
It is! When you're upset in the heart, why would
you
be upset?
Earlier that when you punish your children, it bothers you, but you don't regret.
No, but it's comparing apples and oranges. That's why I'm repeating. In Genesis 3, he was pleased with his creation. In Genesis 6:6, he regretted his creation.
Okay, your father.
You see a contradiction in that?
No.
You don't see a contradiction?
Okay. Sometimes, has it ever happened
that you've already asked me this question?
That your son has done something really good that you're proud of?
Yes.
And at a later date he's done something not good that you're not proud of?
Yes.
So you've gone from a state of being pleased with your son to being unhappy with your son?
Yes.
Is that a contradiction?
No, it's not a contradiction. So Shall I tell you why? Because you see, when you're talking about a creation, yes? I, as a human being, do not know the future. Does God know the future?
Yeah.
Good. Did God know he was the creation that he's going to create are going to be disobedient?
Of course he did.
Good.
Wait. Right now.
I haven't finished.
Let him finish, man.
Let me finish the point. Finish. When God knows the future already, so he knew that they were going to be disobedient. So when he made this statement that I'm pleased with my creation, when he made this statement, he already knew that he's going to be disobedient. The very creation that he created, they're going to be disobedient. So for you to tell me and compare me, a human, with God Almighty who knows the future, is comparing apples and oranges. And this is what I'm telling you, that when you talk about God, then you need to realize that God doesn't regret what he has done. It is something beyond, God's nature to regret something that he already is aware of. Us human beings, we regret our mistakes. We make mistakes because we somehow did not foresee what is going to be repercussions of those mistakes. We did not see it coming. So you might make wrong choice in your life. I might make wrong choices in my life. Yes? Because I don't know what's in store for me tomorrow. Neither do you. But you see, this is something that we cannot apply to God Almighty. God knows exactly what's going to happen tomorrow.
He just said so many times that it doesn't say in the original version.
Well, he read it himself. He read it. What was the word that you used instead of regret? Semantics, my friend. He did regret, whether you like it or not.